musculoskeletal, and then diabetes. And then at the end of the year for your H&P week, you'll do the full head to toe examination. Okay. So for neuro,
neuro pumping.
So we are 4 SPBLs in. So instead of having you guys ask every single review system.
Oh, my God. Bless.
Please. So here, we'll just start from the beginning. So for your neuro SPBL, you will do, like we've always done for the physical exam, you do the focused head and neck exam, and your lung and your heart exam. Okay?
Focused.
And then you do your full neuro exam. Your vitals will be given to you, but you must verbalize it to your SPs. Okay. Now, review of systems. So you must do all the general, all the head, and the full neuro review of systems. And you will choose at least one other pertinent review of systems. And you may choose more than one if you feel is pertinent. And then you ask at least 3 in each system that you choose.
That's
fine.
The one pertinent one that you
choose. So if you only choose one extra review system, you only ask 3 extra questions.
At least 3. But there could be more than one extra pertinent one. Yes?
One more time. So all general, head, and neuro, and then on the pertinent that we choose, it's only 3 questions, or one, or like completely one other that's our choice, and 3 from everything? Only.
No, 3 within the one that you choose.
3 within the one that you choose.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
But you can choose more than one, and just ask 3 from each, every system you choose.
Yeah.
So of course, it's like pertinent ROS, and like do your best, but how are you guys grading on like, you didn't ask this one, you didn't ask this one?
You get to pick what you think is pertinent.
Yeah.
As long as you picked 3 out of that, and then applies to the case.
And as long as, you know, as long as it's pertinent, you know, don't pick
gynecology.
Right. So, right. And let's see. Okay. But you can choose more than one.
But did you say focusing on just the head ROS or like not ROS? Wow.
Head.
So just general,
head. I pick one and then full.
Has 4.
Yeah,
and then the full neuro. So there's plenty of other ones you guys have learned that's probably pertinent to this case. So and then you will do, like we said, a focused head and neck exam, listen to the heart, listen to the lungs. And then you will also do the pertinent family history, social history, probably full medical history. That can include your surgeries, your hospitalizations, immunizations, adult illnesses, and childhood illnesses, medications, allergies. And you guys will be in pairs again, so you will get your schedule on Tuesday. And so it should be the same pair that you had the time before we did the full, right? Because you only went once with that partner, right? So then you guys will swap. So whoever does that will do the opposite. Now there will be one group of 3, just because we have an odd number. So for the group of 3, we kind of decided you would split the work. So usually someone would probably do the history, and then someone could do the cranial nerves, the mini-mental, the motor, and the sensory. And then the other person could do the reflexes, the coordination, gait, and balance. But you guys can work it amongst each other how you really want to do it. But I would suspect that you would want to split the physical exam for the group of 3. Okay. You'll have 45 minutes. The pair of you. And Professor Roark will not be here, so your labs will go to me. So by 2:00 on Wednesday. And we're doing something a little different this time. So You have $5 to spend.
What?
Okay.
But I don't know how much anything costs.
Well, I'm getting ready to tell you.
Okay.
Wait just a minute.
We're gonna give you the fee schedule.
The fee schedule is labs are $1. Imaging is $3. So if you buy an imaging, you can basically only order 2 labs. Or if you don't want to order any imaging, you're able to buy 5 labs. Or you don't have to do any imaging or labs at all.
$6.
Nope.
For 2 labs.
Or for $5.
$5.
Wow. Yes.
Are you saying with labs like one specific lab, or are you talking like
one specific lab?
Okay. So like if
so a CBC is $1.
Okay.
CMP is $1.
If we don't order, if we don't like spend our $5, can it roll over to the next one?
Don't use it, you know. If you don't use it, you lose it.
Deductible, yeah, you're.
And then for on Thursday afternoon, you guys have an opening between 3 and 5. So what I'll do is I'll be over at Kramer in the SP Suites. You guys can come over, work on the physical exam with each other, and I'll be there for any feedback if whoever wants to come.
Thursday
3 to 5.
Oh, this Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
That would be after
the rest
of the meal. I was so confused.
That would do no good.
I thought that Thursday was free.
That's optional, right?
It's optional.
Okay. I'll be there. I just want to make sure.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's optional.
And you might add it. So last time I had them, I took a head count and thought they would come, so
yeah.
We'll see if we need to divide
it. You earn money.
Well, it might earn you another $1. I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Can you buy an extra $1?
Can you buy an extra $1 for having to practice?
You know? There might be a golden ticket there.
Right. There could be a golden ticket.
Could be a golden ticket if you have to practice.
Yes.
Is there a reading assignment based on
an EBM?
Yes.
For this one, I don't remember seeing one.
I think he's going over a systematic review, but
yeah. There's one on this one this week.
Okay. Well, then Dr. Britton or Dr. McNeil will probably upload that to D2L for you all.
Okay.
Yes.
On the mini, do we need to memorize that? Or?
Oh. Okay. So on the mini, you will have cards in the room. You will need to start the mini mental exam. And so once you've asked enough questions that SP thinks that you are okay, then she'll have you move on, he or she. As long as you just remember to do it and you initiate it and start doing it, then you'll get points for it. But you gotta remember to do it. By the next one, we'll give you guys, we should say, we'll just let you guys tell us which one's over. Because, you know, that's why we have you ask them all, so that you can start deciding which one is important in the case. So now you guys can decide which one's important in the case, other than the 3 we gave you. Okay, yes?
Can you go over the major sections? Like, I know we need to do the mini mental. Like
you, so you
just
have the
read
mini
the
mental, you have the cranial nerves, you have motor.
We would like you to inspect for neuro. I don't think Dr. McNeil had that on that checklist, but just say.
I think they're on her, on the checklist that she aired.
No, did we? I don't think it's on there. You need to inspect for, what would you look for if you're
atrophy,
tremors. Articulation,
tremors,
so just inspect a couple of things.
Just overall inspection.
Overall inspection.
It's so funny, we went to eat lunch the other day, we're driving away, and we're like, look at that man's muscle atrophy. You know, he had a cane, you could tell the difference between his 2 legs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's
bad.
So don't forget to inspect. Initiate mini mental.
You have your motor,
cranial nerves,
motor,
sensory,
reflexes,
coordination,
gait, balance. So, as far as doing them, you can either do it in order or kind of do it in blocks. Like you could do the cranial nerves first, then you do your motors, then you do your motor at your upper and lower extremities, then you do the sensory upper and lower, then you do your reflexes, and then coordination gait balance.
You know, and Dr. McNeil talked about you wouldn't normally do vibration, proprioception, all that, unless you already had elicited that they had a sensory deficit of some kind. But for the SPBL, you got to do it all, no matter
if they have
a sensory deficit, just so you can show you know how to do everything. Mm-hmm. But in the real world, you wouldn't do all of that.
Well, all this stuff.
No, focused head and neck exam.
You don't have
them. Oh, the cranial nerves, that's right.
Because
you've done it in
Hino.
And
then I think, are we going to have a little factory stuff?
Yes.
Ryan, do you have a question?
Yeah, can we use a pinwheel?
A what?
Can we use a pinwheel?
Pinwheel?
Pinwheel for neuro sensation. Sharp prick, a little spiky thing. Typical. Instead of breaking a stick and poking me with it, or you just use it?
No, I would do the. You use the.
Okay.
Hot tips.
Alright.
Yeah, I was like, that's when you say pinwheel, that's when I think that blows in the wind. How do you work that on? Sharp, you blow it. Yeah, I think we'll actually have toothpicks, so you don't have to break it. So you'll have cotton tip, and then you'll have toothpicks. And then you'll have the different scents. So on that, you should test two different auditory senses and olfactory, and make sure they close their eyes so they don't see. Unless you can see, like he said, and hide it behind your hand. But one of them's kind of hard to hide behind your hand.
And then what about the options that you have
to hold
for
graft? You can use a pen, you can use anything that's in the room. Most likely, obviously, the easiest. Or a piece of paper, book, whatever you want. Yeah. You hold this book. What else? Same as before, paper turned in by 8 a.m. Friday to your faculty. The debrief schedule will go out on Thursday. Most likely, we'll actually get done in the morning. The debrief shouldn't take as long since you're in pairs. So we could probably do the debrief with the faculty from like 11 to 1 when you guys are done for the afternoon.
And I will be back for the debrief.
You said labs are due Wednesday at 2?
Wednesday at 2. The schedule will go out Tuesday. Next Tuesday. Everyone's like, please let me have the golden ticket. I'm sorry. I don't honestly don't know. I know that I saw the block of three. I don't know who they are. And then don't forget, you know, when you guys are working in pairs, work with each other. So if you notice your partner forgetting a review systems or something on the physical exam, then you know make sure you follow up and do it so that you guys don't lose the points. Okay. What else? Oh yeah, you'll get a 10-minute warning on your dog. Okay.
Will it be new SPs?
Huh?
New SPs? This isn't not important, so.
I can't look Dawn in the eye.
No, this is not important.
Dawn in the eye.